British Columbia, Mr. Ben Crosby. I see, Ben, you're aware of the little Canadian paper that I was recently involved in that story.
You really got the band right, didn't you?
I got the biggest, coldest breath you've ever seen.
That's your own fault, Ben, the way you judge.
I don't know what I judge.
I saw a picture of you in the paper.
Yeah.
You needed a shave, you wore a floppy hat and a beat-up old jacket, and you had a tin cup in your left hand.
Don't you notice a handful of punches on my left? Well, Ken, actually, no matter what you think, I want to tell you, I had very little trouble getting a room at the Hotel Vancouver.
No, you didn't.
No, I didn't. When you bumped, I walked across the street. I checked into another hotel. I took a bath, shaved, changed clothes, went back to the Vancouver, walked up to the bus, and got a room with very little trouble.
No trouble at all.
No trouble.
That's what I've been wondering since that was the hotel took tennis or cast eyes in any way because you didn't know
it
was.
This is surprising, Ken. It's amazing, but as a matter of fact, dubious honor has been heaped upon him.
What do you mean?
He's been appointed president of the Bad Hope Fan Club.
Well, isn't that something?
Well, it certainly is. I'm very nice. I think I see the fellow really has really put him under a trigger. A complete snip with my hat.
Your hat?
Yes. I had hundreds of top flies hooked into the band and onto the broom. And I have to say, yeah, I don't
know. Why don't you that right
now, I thought they were real bad guys, right?
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Time to attack and see for yourself. Do like the Dingle Show. He got a wonderful new gift package, a pack that's close for you to write your own journal.
You'll find it at your favorite Chesterfield dealer. And remember, for Father's Day, it's any day. It's Chesterfield. See you next week for Chesterfield, folks. The best cigarette for you to smoke. Mr. Bud Wheeler and other scintillating personalities.